have with us, but why the hungry?
This was the driving theme that inspired a worldwide movement more than 50 years ago. The United States of America is one of the most industrialized producers of food in the entire world. Here in the U.S., we are so successful at food production that every day, nearly 40% of food produced in America will go uneaten or discarded.
But why the hungry?
Soup kitchens, shelters, and local churches have been providing free meals for over a century. But these places provide one meal at a time, and only to those who are physically able to show up. A place where a family or a shelter could get a week's worth of groceries for all of the people they feed simply did not exist. Until the 1960s, when a compassionate man named John Van Hengel, along with a few other resourceful Phoenicians, came up with a simple yet groundbreaking notion. Gather food where there is an abundance and deliver it to those in need. A simple thought that no one had dreamt prior to 1967.
And St. Mary's tie-up was because St. Mary's was the ones, were the ones that gave us our impetus. They gave us our building to start with. And also they loaned me $3,000 to get this off the ground, which we paid back the first year.
So, with a $3,000 loan from his church, St. Mary's Basilica, John Van Hengel secured an old abandoned bakery in South Phoenix and opened St. Mary's Food Bank, the world's first food bank. So why the name Food Bank?
The lady that we referred to that gave us the name St. Mary's Food Bank was a lady that I was called over to meet one day by one of the social service agencies, and they said, this lady has 10 children and she's been feeding all these children out of the dumpster behind one of the local supermarkets. And of course I was involved at that time in gathering food and storing it. We didn't have a name for our program at the time, and she took me over to the dumpster and showed me the food, and it was unbelievable what was being tossed out. About 2 days later, she came back again and she said, you see these children, they're all healthy. And I said, my gosh, they're a real healthy looking bunch. She said, there should be some kind of a place where people could put in food for those of us in need, and then we could take it out. And she said, kind of a bank-like. And she said, a bank of food. And I said, that's it, a food bank. And so that's where the name came from.
While St. Mary's Food Bank may have invented the first food bank, they're certainly not the only one today. After the first food bank launched in Phoenix, the word quickly spread and other states began to follow John's lead. By 1977, there were food banks in 18 cities across the country. As the number of food banks began to increase, John created a national organization for food banks, and in 1979, he established Second Harvest, later called America's Second Harvest, the nation's food bank network. In 2008, the network changed its name to Feeding America to better reflect the mission of the organization. In 1984, food banking had reached Europe with the establishment of the first food bank in France. By 1999, there were more than 50,000 food pantries established across the U.S., many of which being supplied with food from area food banks. With so many new food banks operating across the world, the Global Food Banking Network was established in 2006. As of 2017, there are more than 200 food banks across the United States and Puerto Rico. Globally, there are hundreds of food banks across 25 countries. The food bank is essentially a food storage and distribution center, a clearinghouse where individuals and businesses donate or deposit excess food or money into the bank. Those in need can then withdraw or pick up large quantities of food for their agency or bring home to their family. Today, food banks have taken the clearinghouse storage concept to remarkable levels. Established food banks like St. Mary's utilize technology, logistics, and thousands of dedicated volunteers in order to provide more than 250,000 pounds of food every day.
As many people as there are out in that waiting room, I don't think any of them really want to be here. But they come out of desperation. And so we try to make their experience as pleasant as we can. And that is our goal, that is our mission here.
Every day, I know that whether or not it's a productive day, things get done the way I want them to get done, whatever we've done, we're moving in the right direction to help feed the community.
There's no trade-off for it. It's just something you feel. You connect with that person. You just, you know, you bring such joy to the public at large by simply just offering a helping hand.
With the support of key private sector relationships, what was once considered the home of dented canned food is now home to fresh produce, dairy, eggs, meat, starches, bottled water, and more.
In a course of a typical month, there's 2 truckloads of eggs, 22 pallets of freshly laid eggs going into St. Mary's. And holiday times, Easter, Thanksgiving, Christmas, we want to make sure, even though we're close on inventory, that we're shipping in for holidays, because that's important for families to have nutritious food. We have a product that's perishable. We need some partner that knows how to get those eggs into people's houses and serve. And St. Mary's knows how to do that.
The relationship with St. Mary's Food Bank and Shamrock goes back almost 50 years. And it started with our chairman, Norman McClellan, who was a part of the volunteer efforts and a part of the startup for the original St. Mary's 50 years ago.
If we didn't have St. Mary's Food Bank, some pellets would sit in the back corner of our cooler, you know, and go to waste until they got mushy and someone remembered about them and they'd go in the landfill and they'd just fill up a landfill. St. Mary's pushes us to check our produce constantly and see if there's anything that we can send to others that don't make the strict standards of the grocery stores. So it's a great way to, you know, feed more people, to use produce that would go unused, and also it keeps us on our toes. It makes us do our job better.
It's natural for Shamrock to be able to partner with a great organization like St. Mary's to be able to help folks.
Local consumption, that is our focus. And you kind of lose the track from in the field to who gets to eat the product at the end of the day. And St. Mary's is a really good way for us to connect with that. We know where it's going. We know who's getting it. It's people that really need it. And it makes what we do a lot more worthwhile.
There's people that stay on the farm all day long making sure that we're getting product to paying customers. And they like to know that the people they're working for care about those in need. And they want to know that we are helping other people.
More than 40% of all the food distributed by St. Mary's Food Bank is fresh Arizona-grown produce.
For $1, we're able to put 7 meals on the table for those in need. And again, that's because of the food that we receive that's donated, as well as all of the volunteer hours that are out there that help us get that done.
Because of these efficiencies, St. Mary's Food Bank is able to provide food assistance to over 2/3 of Arizona, from Phoenix to the northern border and everywhere in between. It was once thought that people receiving assistance at food banks are primarily comprised of the homeless looking for a handout. Actually, they often have jobs, families, or they may have even served our country. You may not recognize them because they're just like the rest of us, only perhaps in the midst of hard times, a health issue, underemployment, between jobs or education. They're making difficult decisions every day, like paying the power bill or putting food on the table. Should they put gas in the car that gets them to work or feed their children for the week? This is where St. Mary's Food Bank provides the biggest impact.
So the general public many times believes that the people that we serve are just looking for a handout.
Most of our clients are the working poor. These are people that are working every day to provide for themselves and their families, but simply don't have enough income.
You know, there's many different choices that parents have to make to, okay, do I slack off on the food for my children, or do I make sure that our electricity's on?
My mom always taught me bills first and then food later, so the food is a little short sometimes.
I don't go get food stamps. I don't go get assistance. I depend, you know, when I need food, I come here.
I only work part-time because I take care of my parents, so, it's like food bank. Maybe they can help me out a little bit. So I came in, and that's how I learned about St. Mary's.
I depend on St. Mary's at times when I'm not working to keep me in between with food supplied until I find work.
St. Mary provides security for food when my family is in hard times and needs.
Well, I take care of my mom and dad, and there's myself, and I take care of 2 grandchildren, so I have a 13-year-old and a 15-year-old that I take care of also. Boy, can they eat.
I have 6 members of my family, myself, my fiance, and our 4 children.
I have had to receive emergency food boxes in the past. They've definitely helped out. as far as, you know, making sure that the food was able to stretch, food remained on the table, and my children never went hungry.
Because there's times that some people will come to my house and knock on my door and say, Darla, I don't have any food. Is there any way that you can help me out, you know, which I barely have, but I'm still able to bless because St. Mary's has blessed me.
I'm a single mom with two kids, and it's really hard to make ends meet nowadays.
Well, it definitely supplements the deficiency, you know, when we need help.
Well, towards the end of the month, when we don't have, like, food or money to spend, we get the food boxes and they help as well.
I go there once a month to have an emergency food box because I'm not working, it's only my husband that's working, so we needed it desperately. So St. Mary's Food Bank has been a big benefit to my family.
St. Mary's helps me where it provides food on my table where I don't have to worry about what's going to happen the next day.
I'm one of six kids from rural southern Arizona where access to a grocery store was more than nearly an hour away. And our rural elementary school was able to offer free and reduced priced breakfast and lunch for kids like me and my five brothers and sisters that would otherwise not be able to afford a meal at school.
Well, I heard about it when I was out on the streets homeless and stuff, and they would help us out with me and my kids with food boxes when I couldn't provide food for them.
It helps us by providing what we didn't have before, and it kind of takes that feeling of desperation away.
It makes me as a mother excited to feed my son because he's excited and happy as well as I am.
Whenever I've received that help from St. Mary's, it's helped me out in a lot of different directions. It does free up, you know, a little bit of extra cash or whatnot. It helps give me those little essentials to help spread what we already have. It relieves the stress because, I mean, nobody wants to see their kid not eat or not have their choice of what they're eating. So it's definitely helped move stress around a lot in my life.
It makes me feel awesome to be able to provide food for my children.
There's no shame in asking for food assistance. There's only respect and compassion for better days ahead. At the Knight Center in Phoenix and Surprise, Arizona, thousands of food assistance boxes are distributed to families each day. The process is less intimidating than most people think. Caring professionals and volunteers guide people through every step, assuring they receive the support and services they need.
They respect you. You keep your pride, and they're here to help you.
It was warm and inviting, and everybody was a caring attitude. That's what's so important about St. Mary's.
When I went to St. Mary's Food Bank, they treated me very special, like I was important there too.
My favorite thing about St. Mary's has to be the attitude of everybody, the attitude of the institution itself. They're about helping people in whichever different direction, whether that be making sure that the food stays on the table or providing with opportunities to improve your own life so you have that opportunity to put the food on the table on your own.
It's really easy and relaxed in the environment. You don't feel like less of a person when you go in.
Who wants to go and say that they don't have enough food for their family? But then when you get there, they make you feel comfortable and, you know, you see other people that look like you.
The atmosphere is they're very nice and pleasant people. They're always smiling. They're not rude.
Once I became an employee here at St. Mary's Food Bank, I got to see how it runs from the inside. So I never really understood how I was able to get the food that I was getting for free. So working here, it gave me a better understanding of how it was able to be provided for me.
When I was waiting on the line, a lady walked up to me. She went for a box too. And she handed me, I don't know where she got it, she handed me $100. She said, do you have kids? And I said, yes. She said, please get a Christmas gift for them. I have never forgotten that. Because of that gesture, I have always said to myself, I will help people as long as I live. Because the people that have been gracious to me, I've never known them in my whole life.
It's the people that work for St. Mary's because they don't judge you, they don't disrespect you, and I love the food that they give. I'm not gonna lie, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
people who can't make it to the food bank are still eligible to receive assistance. St. Mary's delivers food to more than 40 rural and urban locations throughout central and northern Arizona with its mobile pantry program. A St. Mary's food bank truck brings perishable food directly to neighborhoods in the greatest need. Pallets of fruit, vegetables, and bread are available for dozens of families needing the nutritious food. This massive endeavor is accomplished through a fleet of over 50 vehicles that travel annually over 1.4 million miles to distribute, rescue food, meet with partner agencies, and mobile pantry sites. That's as many miles as traveling around the world over 56 times. In addition to directly supporting people and families within the community, St. Mary's Food Bank provides the bulk of its food donations to other nonprofits throughout Arizona.
Shelters for the abused, homes for the aged, halfway houses, alcoholic rehabilitation centers, any nonprofit organization that feeds people gets food from us.
Agency services is the conduit between us acting as a wholesaler and the ultimate client. They're the ones who ultimately provide the food. They, in many cases, they cook it. They're the ones we have to serve.
The bulk of the 250,000 pounds of food distributed every day are comprised of donations to nearly 500 partner nonprofits throughout central and northern Arizona.
We rely so heavily on St. Mary's for the nutritional meal for our guests. If we didn't come to St. Mary's, it would be a big, big financial loss for us, and we would not be able to cater to our guests in the best way. So it is a really, really big gift that we are able to come here.
I came here and I figured out what we were doing here and how to take advantage of it and use it for our services. The money that I save by coming to St. Mary's can go to other programs within Sojourner Center.
Innovation and efficiency has been a staple theme at St. Mary's Food Bank since inception, and that innovation has led to additional programs that have spawned the same overwhelming spirit of giving. After all, the St. Mary's Food Bank mission statement is to alleviate hunger through the gathering and distribution of food while encouraging self-sufficiency, collaboration, advocacy, and education. Following the notion, teach a man to fish and he could feed his family for life, St. Mary's Food Bank created a program called Community Kitchen in 2000. Community Kitchen is a life skills and food service training program for those who struggle to find employment. It gives people a chance to transform their future, to be self-sufficient by learning hands-on food service training. The kitchen has also provided thousands of meals to those in need.
We are a program that helps individuals who are looking to make a change in their life provide for themselves. The mission is to help disadvantaged adults achieve self-sufficiency through training and job placement, but I look at it as a little bigger than that. I want to see people be successful.
They give you the opportunity. They give you the skills, and it's up to you to take those skills and that opportunity and run with it.
The main criteria to become a student, you're going to be facing some sort of barrier to employment. Whether that was an incarceration, whether that was you're a victim of domestic violence, substance abuse and recovery. I have some individuals who are 18 years old and have no hireable skills yet, have never really worked, but are now in a position where they need to provide for themselves. So we're able to kind of give them that springboard into a career.
I was in federal prison prior to coming to St. Mary's as a student. I was an addict, a drug addict, and so that kind of led me to prison. And then once I got to prison, naturally I came out. And then when I came here, I found a lot of support through the community kitchen staff, and that really helped me keep my life in the right direction.
I was living in a halfway house due to my own poor decisions, and was working in the evenings and was really looking for something to do during the day to make myself better. I always enjoyed cooking. I was working on a food truck, and I stumbled upon this program, saw what they were doing here, and wanted to be a part of it. So we are a 12-week program. You are here Monday through Friday from 7 to 3. So 40 hours a week for 12 weeks is a huge commitment, but it is an investment in oneself.
I was contacted by somebody through a community kitchen, asked to do mock interviews, and I was told a little bit about the program, and I thought it was remarkable because I see chefs come into our kitchen all the time that they've gone to culinary school, like known culinary recognized programs, and these people have not the best work ethic, and remarkably not the best skill set, culinary skill set. And I get these kids coming in with a huge debt and huge egos. And when I was explained what Community Kitchen does and who these people are and where they're coming from and how badly they want this opportunity, it touched my heart.
In Community Kitchen, the very first thing that we started learning was with the knife skills and the life skills. They sat down with us, taught us some nice coping mechanisms, because most of us come from some checkered backgrounds, which means we don't cope with a lot too well at all.
They taught me a lot of life skills here, and they kept in touch with me after they got, because I went out and worked for a year out into the community. They found me a job, and then they asked me to come back and interview for this position.
The knife skills aside and the kitchen skills aside, it's the life skills portion. It's the birth or rebirth of self-confidence you see a lot in the students. The ability to know that they have a skill they can take out into the world and provide for themselves when they've never been given that opportunity up until this point, I think is the most powerful piece.
Since I'm a foreigner, I have not had the opportunity to go to school or the privilege, the money, the time to go to school, because I was raising two girls on my own. And when I heard about this program, I jumped to it, because I will not have had this opportunity, not ever.
I even took a cut in pay for my job because this is where I wanted to be. I knew that I could relate to the students. I found friends here that, I still talk to this day. We encourage each other.
To me, we're the back half of St. Mary's mission statement. Right, to alleviate hunger, obviously the front half, but then encouraging self-sufficiency through collaboration and education, we take it a step farther. We're producing that self-sufficiency, right? So we're an integral piece of the St. Mary's mission statement. Beyond, just providing hope for someone in a meal, providing hope for someone in the ability to produce meals for themselves for a long time.
For me, it's not just teaching them how to cook, it's also teaching them how to become a better person.
I met Alan, within just a few months. He's just recently joined our team. I called up Community Kitchen. I was looking for a chef. I had one of my tried and true chefs move on to something else in a different state, and I had a hole. I had a vacancy in my staff. So we arranged a time, and Alan showed up, and we put every Community Kitchen graduate through the same process as I would everybody else. And Alan brought a stellar reputation. They talked very highly of Alan, so I was excited to meet him before I even met him. He's shining brightly, he's doing a great job.
When I thought that, after I graduated, that they'd help me get that first job, and then, they kind of pat me on the back and see me along the way, it wasn't quite the way it worked out. It really has turned into more of a family. They constantly reach out, if even just to check on you. Hey, how you doing out there? Are you enjoying your job right about now? My goals are to continue to learn. I don't care if I've opened my own restaurant and reached the top of 5 Michelin stars. My goal is to continuously learn every day, grow as a person, and help my community around me grow in the same manner.
In our 17-year history, we've graduated 103 classes, which puts us right at 900 graduates. So 900 people we were able to get out into the workforce that didn't have that skill set before they came to us.
To give yourself that opportunity to give back.
Teach a man to fish, right? And he never goes hungry. So we really sort of provide that piece.
One other aspect of the Community Kitchen is CK Catering, a social enterprise business teaching the students an additional business skill. CK Catering provides food for parties, lunches, or elegant dinners while assisting community members in developing job skills to provide for themselves. The compassion for helping those in need is especially great when addressing child hunger. 1 in 4 children in Arizona live in poverty, one of the highest rates in the nation. While they may have breakfast and lunch at school, they might not get enough food at night and on the weekends. Hence, Kids Cafe, a St. Mary's food bank program that ensures children get one more healthy meal before they leave school at the end of the day. More than 1 million healthy meals are delivered annually to students in after-school and summer programs. What's more, the Backpack program sends approximately 700 chronically hungry children home with food on Fridays to ensure they have something to eat over the weekend.
St. Mary's Food Bank has played a very important role in our school with the students. After lunch, they go back to their classrooms, but before they go home, they come back here again. And we give them the Kids Cafe, those wonderful packets of food that they have. They all look forward to it. They come rushing into the kitchen.
It's helpful for me because when I go home, I don't have to make such hearty meals. I can make something a little lighter because they've already ate at school.
We have
over 500 students here, and we've been preparing food, nutritious food for these kids for more than 3 years here now, and it's really been wonderful here.
I eat breakfast because it helps me learn in class. I like apples, grapes, carrots, and lettuce.
We have over 90% of students having food assistance here, free and reduced meals that we serve to them.
If I didn't have breakfast, I think I would get a lower grade, like a D.
When you have a kid who hasn't had any breakfast at all, you're sure that that kid won't be able to digest whatever the teacher is saying. So that is the most important meal that we serve to the kids.
If I missed a meal, I wouldn't be able to concentrate.
It's hard to concentrate when you're hungry.
There was a time that kids would come just late from wherever they're coming. They come in and they're like, I'm hungry, I didn't have breakfast. And so I would gather some apples and I would give it to them because they need that so they could understand and focus the learning.
If they don't have dinner at home, it's either they just save, like they eat part of the Kids Cafe meal and save it until they get hungry again.
And they're very grateful for the St. Mary's Food Bank.
What started out as an innovative idea to help feed the hungry has blossomed into a worldwide movement. Currently, there are over 200 food banks in the United States and hundreds more around the world, helping tens of millions of people every day find their next meal and transition into self-sustainability. All thanks to a man and his desire to help those in need. 50 years later, St. Mary's Food Bank will be distributing its 1 billionth pound of food. That's enough to feed the entire population of the United States, breakfast, lunch, dinner, with plenty of leftovers.
Poor we will always have with us, but why the hunger?
And St. Mary's has a reputation for caring for people, no matter what. They're in it to end hunger and close their doors.
I really wish that down the road there would be no need for us here.
With the great donor base that we have, we can truly eliminate hunger throughout our service area.
And there'd be nothing more that we'd like to see than St. Mary's Food Bank be out of business because there are no hungry people in our community.
Since 1967, St. Mary's Food Bank remains a team of extraordinarily compassionate and innovative people who just happen to be operating the world's first food bank. Their number one goal remains to work themselves out of business when going out of business means ending hunger. And for that, tens of millions of people around the world are grateful.
Congratulations to St. Mary's Food Bank, the first food bank in the United States of America, feeding Phoenix for 50 years. What an incredible achievement.
St. Mary's Food Bank, happy 50th anniversary.
From the Secretary of State's office, happy birthday, St. Mary's Food Bank, and thank you for all that you do.
You do wonderful things for people, but you have wonderful people who do wonderful things. Thank you to them and the food bank and all you've done all these years. God bless on the 50th.
Happy 50th anniversary. You've helped Arizona for a half a century and been a model for the rest of the country. That's a great thing.
St. Mary's will continue to fulfill their mission for decades to come. Thank you for feeding those in need for 50 years.
Congratulations to St. Mary's Food Bank for the 50 years of service.
St. Mary's Food Bank is so important to the Phoenix community. Without St. Mary's, too many Arizonans would be left without access to healthy food. Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
I'm so proud to be mayor of the city that is home to the very best food bank in the world. St. Mary's Food Bank, happy anniversary.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank. Thank you for being a part of the Flagstaff community.
On behalf of the Hickman family and our 1,000 strong staff, happy Hatch Day. Happy 50th anniversary to everybody at St. Mary's, and we hope to end hunger.
Congratulations to you, and from the bottom of my heart, thank you for all you do for our community.
Happy 50th anniversary to all of my friends at St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
I want to thank St. Mary's Food Bank for feeding the hungry here in Arizona for the past 50 years. Happy birthday.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank. Thank you for feeding those in need for 50 years.
Happy 50th birthday to St. Mary. And thank you for all you do for Arizona's hungry.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
I want to wish the St. Mary's Food Bank a happy 50 years.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary to St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Hi, St. Mary's. Thanks for all you do. You're moving mountains. You know the way. Love is the road.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
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 Happy 50th anniversary to St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank Alliance.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 15th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary to St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary to St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary to St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy 50th anniversary, St. Mary's Food Bank.
Happy anniversary!
Happy birthday, St. Mary's Food Bank, from Houston Food Bank.
Woo!